that steel pole is unforgiving, and you just have to figure it out. And even my teacher, who was more of a Cirque du Soleil acrobatic pole dancer, is like, this is all normal. And I was like, this is chafing is normal? This, yeah, these bruises are normal? When I was a kid, I always wanted to work with animals. I was close.
When pitching an idea like this, it's not a black and white story, of course. I think it's hard to get any movie made, obviously, but certainly any movie made nowadays, but I think it's especially hard to get movies made about women doing questionable things.
About women, period.
Yeah, about women, period. About women like these women, though, not just where they ended up, but where they started from. I think that's where the judgment actually begins, is the stigma around what these women did for a living, stripping, dancing at clubs. And so I did want to tell a human story. Writing for me is always an exercise in empathy. So I wanted to empathize with kind of all of us who are up against this broken value system and show these women in a different light.
First of all, it's hard to make movies, period. You know, It has to be like a Marvel comic or, you know, some crazy
franchise thing.
But in the smaller, more movies about humanity and people and life and struggles and things like, you don't get that as much unless you like do it for nothing. And we couldn't make that movie this way, but it is hard. And on top of just the movies itself, then when you have women characters at the front of it, it's a whole nother battle. It is another layer, and it is hard to get them made. And so you take this and you go, yeah, it's starring all women. No, there's no really male characters in it. And they're hurting men. And they're like,
And it looks brilliant. You know what I mean? I remember I was talking to Lorene about it. It's like you only see those kinds of shots and this kind of eloquence visually when it's guys. You know, you only get to see them in the powerful shots walking down the hallway looking dope, looking cool. Like, aside from the depth, aside from the great nuances of the actors and the characters, it's very cinematic. And that's what I first thought when I saw the movie.
Yes, Kiki.
I mean, it really is. It's crazy when you come in and out of the shots, the way the story is told, how the perspectives are looked when you, it was, it's really sick.
It was fun to tell an epic story about women. I think that is what you mean. It's
anti-hero.
But we get a lot of smaller stories. I think people assume our lives are small stories. And I think that contributes to the amount of female speaking roles in these movies like this. And so in the last 20 years, there hasn't been an Academy Award winning picture with women talking to each other, I think, besides Chicago, where they sing to each other. So
seriously?
It's pretty shocking. I think an epic story was really what I was so interested in telling.
The game is rigged, and it does not reward people who play by the rules.
It's like robbing a bank, except you get the keys. Are you in?
I read the script, and I thought right away, obviously, Ramona was a great character. I like movies that, yes, it's about the people, but it's also about something bigger. It's a more universal kind of story about life and survival and greed and desperation and what people do. Like, to me, that's really interesting. And I saw that in the script right away, but I wanted to meet Lorene. We sat down, we talked about it, and I was like, I kind of see it like this kind of thing. How do you see it? And she was like, that's exactly how I see it. I was like, oh my God, yes, okay. We have to do this.
You want them drunk enough to get their credit card, but sober enough to sign a check.
I think it's a feminist story, and it depends on how you define feminism, which I think is just equality. And one of the reasons I think it's especially feminist is because we are taking women who have previously been judged and shamed by society and getting to know them as people instead of as objects or as their occupations. And I think that is the true spirit of feminism, is humanity.
I think there are like five different ways that you could tell this story. And what I love so much about what you, Lorene, did is telling the story with compassion and showing many, many different perspectives on these events. And I do think that ties into feminism, because it could have easily been a story about demonizing these women and how they victimized men, and you did the opposite.
What's up, baby?
We're gonna help her learn how to do a real dance.
Oh, I'm good at that.
We had the camera test, which was kind of the first day we met, and, you know, she was there just looking amazing in costume and hair and makeup and everything. And I was like, oh my God, what am I doing here? And then I just walked up next to her and she put her arm around me. And I mean, she's just the most caring person. And I instantly felt like I was being taken care of, like a sort of big sister, little sister vibe.
Sometimes you don't have a natural chemistry with the actor you're working with and you have to create it. But sometimes it's more natural. There's a natural chemistry and that kind of pops off the screen. And I think that's what happened with me and Constance.
We're a family now. Damn, a family with money.
I said to Lorene, I said, I think that Ramona should dance in the beginning instead of just be seen in the club. And I said, what do you think of that? I think I could learn how to pole dance. She goes, you don't have to. I was like, I want to.
Yeah.
think if we're doing this, we can't not have that be an element, especially since she's supposed to be the best, you know, dancer, performer, has it all figured out in the club. She has to make somewhat of an entrance. I think it would be good to just have her do a pole dance at the beginning. She's like, yeah, I love it. I said, what about Wicked Game? There's a version that a woman sings that we could do. And she was like, what about Criminal by Fiona Apple? And I was like, love it. Yes, let's do it. And I don't know how we licensed it. We just asked.
Honestly, I think
I was a part of that process.
I mean, you know, I wrote a letter, of course, but I think a lot of it had to do with what the scene is representing, and she's also now giving all the money that she makes from Criminal. She's giving that to refugees, so she's having an actual impact on people's lives as a result of the song being used in this movie.